Hey there, my name is Kaylee, and today we're going to learn about a different way of writing and reading numbers from almost 3,000 years ago. Are you ready? Let's go! I'm sure you've seen a clock that looks like this, but have you ever seen a clock that looks like this? The numbers on this clock are the symbols we're used to seeing. These are called Arabic numerals. The numbers on this clock are written as symbols that might not look very familiar to you. They are called Roman numerals. Roman numerals were invented by ancient Romans in 500 BC as a way to represent numbers and do basic math like addition and subtraction. As the Roman Empire spread, so did the use of Roman numerals, until much of Europe and North Africa was using Roman numerals to represent numbers. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to read and write Roman numerals and some general rules these symbols follow. Did you know you can use just these three symbols to count to 10? I is 1, V is 5, and X is 10. So how do we count every number to 10 with only these? Let me show you. Here's how we count from 1 to 3 in Roman numerals. 1, 2, 3. Pretty easy, right? Can you guess what 4 looks like in Roman numerals? If you guessed 4 ones, you're actually not correct. The actual Roman numeral for the number 4 is IV. Say what? Seems tricky, right? So now I will tell you the first rule of Roman numerals. We can never use more than 3 of the same symbols in a row. That's why we can't write 4 as 4 I's. This fourth identical symbol breaks the rule. Okay, so back to our symbol for 4, IV. We know that the I represents 1. But what does this V mean? V is the symbol for 5. Nice. So let's take a second to think about our symbol for the number 4. By putting an I before V, what we really said was 5 take away 1. So this is another rule of Roman numerals. Whenever we put an I before a symbol, what we're really saying is 1 subtracted from that number. Before we finish counting to 10, let's review our two rules. Rule 1 says we can't put more than 3 identical symbols in a row. That's why when we're writing 4, we can't write it as 4 I's. It's not allowed. And rule 2 says anytime we put an I in front of a bigger symbol like V, it means we subtract 1 from the bigger number. Now let's start where we left off, at 5. We know the symbol for 5 is V. Can you guess what the symbol for 6 is? It's just the opposite of 4. The symbol for 6 is VI. Time for another rule. When we have a symbol for a smaller number, like I for 1, after a larger symbol like V for 5, that means we add the larger number. So now let's use this rule and what we know about putting identical symbols next to each other and come up with the Roman numerals for 7. What do you think? That's right. VII is 7. Now how about 8? We can use those same two rules that tell us that VIII is 8. Now let's make sure we understand this. So B is equal to 5. And we have the symbols for the smaller numbers after V. And that means we add. So this is saying 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 8. Perfect. But what do you notice about our symbol for 8? How many identical symbols are there in a row? Yeah, we have 3 I's in a row. So how do I write out 9? We can't just add another I to 8. We need to know the symbol for 10. X is the Roman numeral symbol for 10. So how did those ancient Romans write the number 9? That's right, just like we wrote 4 is 5 minus 1, we can write 9 as 10 minus 1, which will look like IX. So now we can add a third rule to our Roman numeral rules. What rule helped us write 6, 7, and 8? Rule 3 says an I after a symbol for a larger number, like V, means add to the larger number. Great work! You're ready to read and write using Roman numerals I, V, and X on your own. Join me in the next video to learn about reading and writing to 39 in Roman numerals. You can practice reading and writing up to 10 on your own. In the lesson, there will be a few questions towards the end where you have to add. All you need to do is think about what the Roman numerals represent, add them together to find the sum that's also written as a Roman numeral. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.